Hey everyone, in this video we're going to be coding the right Riemann sum in Python. Let's briefly recall what Riemann sums are. Riemann sums are a numerical method that allows us to approximate a definite integral. These are the simplest forms of numerical integration and are commonly taught in early calculus courses. The right Riemann sum will use the upper right part of a triangle to approximate the area under the curve, hence the name. This schematic here should make this more clear. I'm going to be coding this in PyCharm, which is a free, downloadable, integrated design environment. Let's begin by creating a new file. Then, we will need to import our relevant Python libraries. As we are going to both be approximating the definite integral and graphing our function, we need two Python libraries. We're going to need NumPy and Matplotlib. Let's come to our interpreter in the bottom right. As you can see, it says RRS, which is what we created initially. Let's click this and hit Interpreter Settings. This is very important, as if you have the wrong interpreter selected, Python won't recognize the packages that you're downloading. You can change the interpreter up here at the top. Once you have the right interpreter selected, let's click on this small plus sign down here, and then we will search for NumPy, select it, and click Install Package. Then, we will repeat the same thing for Matplotlib. Now that all of our relevant Python packages are installed, let's close this window. Now that the packages are installed to our Python's virtual environment, we need to import them. So let's type import numpy as mp and import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Next, we need to create two function definitions. One for our function that we are going to be approximating the integral for, and another optional function for its derivative if you wish to find the maximum error. Both these functions will take in some value, x, and return the result of our desired function. Let's now list out some of our function parameters. We're going to initiate an iteration variable that we'll use later. Then, we have our lower integration bound a, our upper integration bound b, and our number of equally spaced subintervals. Then, let's make this formula to find our step size dx. Then let's create a variable for our starting x point, and that is going to be our lower integration bound a plus our step size dx, as our first value will be found at a plus our step size. Then lastly, we'll initiate a variable called area sum to keep track of our rectangle area every time we count a new one. In order to plot our function using matplotlib, we need to create values for it to plot. To do this, I'm going to make a variable, x, which uses NumPy's linspace method. This creates a simple 1D matrix of n plus 1 sections from A to B. We use n plus 1 here, as our number of inputs needed are always 1 more than our number of subsections. Then, to find the outputs of all these equally spaced intervals, all we need to do is call our earlier function with the 1D matrix as our input variable. And that'll simply evaluate every x point that we give it. We're now going to create a right Riemann sum loop. I'm going to create it in two ways. Firstly, we're going to use a while loop. We can say that while I is strictly less than our number of subintervals, our area is our step size times the function evaluated at the right side of our rectangle. We then add this value to our area sum term, increase our x positioning and our iteration counter, and then let the loop continue. Secondly, we could use NumPy's sum method to just take our 1D y matrix with all but our first x value times our step size. Both these methods shown will give the same result. Let's just go ahead and print the results of both these methods to validate that they are indeed the same. And there you go. Next, let's add in a way of calculating the maximum error of our right Riemann sum. This section will be finding the maximum first derivative of our function that will then be plugged into the following formula. Our 1D matrix of x prime here is just saying that within the bounds a to b, create an arbitrary amount of inputs. I just put n times 100. The more points created here, the more accurate your answer will be, with the trade-off of slightly longer program runtimes. Printing the maximum error, we can see that the more subintervals we have, our maximum possible error decreases as we would expect. At this point, we are essentially done with creating our right Riemann sum. I'm just going to add a small fprint statement that returns our value and the maximum possible error that we just found. Lastly, I am just going to add a couple of lines of matplotlib code to print out our bar graph with markers to demonstrate our right Riemann sum. Recall that this square bracket is calling all the values but the first one, as the right Riemann sum does not use a, or said another way, our initial x value. As you can see, increasing our number of subintervals allows us to approach our analytical solution that is 305.3. Additionally, if you want to add more of your function to our matplotlib graph, we can just add this little bit of code here that will evaluate our function beyond our bounds of a and b. Recall that this final parameter is simply our number of inputs evaluated, so too few and our graph will look non-smooth. Lastly, this later line will add it to our plot output, and there we go. We have now just coded a very simple right Riemann sum that can find you the right Riemann sum, the right Riemann sum maximum error, and provide you with a simple graph. I will add that this is not the most intricate or concise Riemann sum code. I just wanted to ensure that it was simple and easy to read above all else. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to code the right Riemann sum in Python. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.